Look at these two x-rays. The first patient presented with dyspnea and cough for 3 months, and we see that there is presence of lucent lesion in the left upper zone. The second patient, he presented with hemoptysis and cough for 3 months. Here we can see lucent lesion in the left upper and middle zone with thick wall. What is the diagnosis in both these cases? Is it cavity, bulla, pneumatocele or bronchiectasis? Pause this video for a few seconds to have your opinion on a piece of paper for both these cases and then proceed with the video to check if you are correct. Welcome to Radio Clinics. In this video, I'll be discussing on approach to lucent disease of the lungs in an x-ray. First, let's start with bulla. Bulla is usually associated with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or it may also be associated with alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency when it occurs in young patient. Bullas are characterized by lucent lesion with hairline thin wall and have size more than 1 cm. There are other features of COPD associated with the bulla, like flattening of the diaphragm. Here we can see that there is flattening of the diaphragm. Diaphragm is supposed to be dome shaped, but here it appears flat. We can also see hyperinflation of the chest. Normally we can see 6 anterior and 10 posterior ribs in the thorax in an x-ray, but here we can see that there are 8 anterior ribs and 11 posterior ribs visible. These oblique ones are the anterior ribs and these horizontal ones are the posterior ribs. We can also see the tubular configuration of the heart. These are all the features of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. In this x-ray, we can also see that there are lucent areas in the both lower zones, and both these lucent areas have hairline thin wall. So these are pulmonary bullas. So this patient has chronic obstructive pulmonary disease with emphysematous lungs and multiple bullas. When similar lucencies with hairline thin wall are sized less than 1 cm, then they are known as blebs. Blebs are also associated with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Now coming to cavity, if the wall of the lesion is perceptible and is more than 3 mm in thickness, then it is known as a cavity. In this x-ray, we can see that there is a presence of lucent lesion in the right middle zone, which has perceptible wall, and this wall is more than 3 mm in thickness. So this is a cavity. If there is presence of fluid in the cavity, or if there is presence of air fluid level within the cavity, it is commonly due to abscess formation or from hemorrhages within the cavity. In this x-ray, we can see that there is a lucent lesion in the right middle zone, and this lucent lesion has perceptible wall which measures more than 3 mm in thickness. This lesion also has air fluid level with dependent area containing fluid and non-dependent area containing air. This is a case of lung abscess. So when cavity is filled with fluid, it is commonly due to lung abscess or may also be from hemorrhage within the cavity. While looking at the characteristics of the cavity, we can also differentiate benign from malignant cavity lesions. Benign cavities have thin to intermediate thick wall, which are less than 15 mm in thickness. Malignant cavity have thick wall of more than 15 mm thickness. Benign cavities have regular inner margins, while malignant cavities, they have irregular nodular inner margins. The walls of the malignant cavity are asymmetrically thick, which means they may be thicker on one side and thinner on the next side. Benign cavities are usually associated with surrounding consolidation and nodules because they are usually associated with infection. Malignant cavity may not be associated with surrounding consolidation or nodules. In this first x-ray, we can see that there is presence of lucent area in the right upper and middle zone. This lucent lesion has thick wall and the wall is nodular and has asymmetrical thickness. So it is more thick on the lower aspect while it is less thick on the upper aspect. This is a case of malignant cavity lesion. In the second x-ray, however, we can see that the wall of the cavity is thin and we can also appreciate that it is regular in appearance. There is no any nodularity associated, hence this is a benign cavity lesion. There is also presence of air fluid level within the cavity, which suggests that this benign cavity lesion is an abscess. There may be other lucences in an X-ray as well. Those are pneumatoceles and bronchiectasis. Pneumatoceles are usually associated with staphylococcal infection and are usually transient. Pneumatoceles also have wall thickness of more than 1 mm. It may be very difficult, if not impossible, to differentiate pneumatocele from a benign cavity lesion. Bronchiectasis is characterized by dilatation of the bronchi. Bronchiectasis usually occurs in clusters. So there are multiple lucences in bronchiectasis which form clustered appearance, and this gives rise to honeycombing appearance in an X-ray. For example, we can see in this X-ray there are multiple lucences which are clustered to each other, forming honeycombing appearance, and this is the case of right middle lobe bronchiectasis. Finally, coming to our query, in the first X-ray we can see that there is lucency in the left upper zone with hairline just perceptible wall, hence it is a left upper lobe bulla. In the second X-ray we can see that the lucency in the left upper and middle zone has a definite wall, hence this is a cavity, and the wall of the cavity appears thick, nodular, and asymmetrically irregular in the inner aspect. So we can see that there is irregularity in the inner aspect of the cavity here, and it is asymmetrically more thick on the upper region and less thick on the lower aspect of the cavity. So this feature suggests that this cavity is a malignant cavity lesion. Sometimes via an X-ray we may be confused in differentiating benign from malignant cavity lesion, and that problem will be solved by a contrast in a CT scan. Thank you.